Looking for an easy way to use proxies with Playwright? We'll show you how to add them in your JavaScript code. Start by installing the Node.js package, Playwright, and a text editor of your choice. Then, in your text editor, open a new file. First, let's import the Chromium module from Playwright. If you prefer another browser, enter a module of your choice. Create the main async function and call it. For the following steps, you'll need proxy details. To get those, head to the Smartproxy dashboard. You can choose any proxy type. But today, I will go with residential proxies. Click on Residential Proxies and select Residential. In the Authentication Method section, click on Create User. Type in the username of your choice and hit Create User again. The password will be generated for you. Alternatively, you can whitelist your IP by clicking Add next to your current IP address. Now navigate to the Endpoint Generator. Here you can choose a preferred proxy user, location, session type, and output format. Below, you will find the generated endpoints. Copy this bit and head back to the text editor. Create a proxy variable and paste the endpoint and port as a value. Define launch options for the browser and assign the proxy to the server variable. In the next two lines, enter Smartproxy username and password. If you choose IP whitelisting, leave the values empty. The headless Boolean determines whether the code runs in headless mode or on screen. If you want to see your browsers in action, enter false. Let's check if the proxies actually work. To do this, we'll need to create a browser constant and launch it with the launch options. Then initiate a try-catch finally statement and open a new browser page. The next line navigates to a specific URL. Here you can enter the address of your preferred IP checker. After that, we'll print the IP address from the website in the console. The following code will catch any errors and log them to the console. And finally, end the session by closing the browser window. Save the file and run it in your terminal or CMD. To see if your proxies work, check the IP address in the console. It's different from our original IP, meaning the proxy setup is successful. You'll find the full code in the video description. For more guides like this, visit our YouTube channel and documentation.